Hello everybody, I am Dr. S.K.Mittal. In this lecture, I will explain the operation of single phase, full wave, fully controlled bridge type AC to DC converter or rectifier. For this rectifier or for this AC to DC converter, single phase AC supply voltage will be converted into DC. Full wave means positive and negative, both half cycles will be rectified. And fully controlled means the bridge configuration of AC to DC converter will consist of 4 SCRs. Therefore, it is known as fully controlled bridge type AC to DC converter. The circuit diagram of this AC to DC converter is made in following way. This wedge rectifier consists of 4 SCRs. 2 SCRs are used to rectify positive half cycle, and remaining 2 SCRs are used to rectify negative half cycle. Here T1 and T2 will rectify. Suppose this is the single phase AC supply voltage. The positive half cycle will be rectified by T1 and T2 SCRs, whereas this negative half cycle will be rectified by SCRs T3 and T4. So this is the configuration of 4 SCRs, and this configuration consists of 4 SCRs. The SCRs are control devices, therefore this is known as fully controlled. And here single phase AC supply voltage will be connected. Here is the single phase AC supply voltage. Suppose this is the L terminal and this is the N terminal. Here is the single phase AC supply. This single phase AC supply is generally represented by Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t, where Vm is the maximum value of supply voltage, and this is the nature of the waveform which we have to rectify. Now the working of this fully controlled rectifier, we will first consider with resistive load. Therefore, at the output terminal of this rectifier, a resistive load RL will be connected between, suppose, terminals A and B. This is the direction of output current and this is the polarity of DC voltage V0. So this is the complete circuit diagram of full wave, fully controlled bridge type AC to DC converter with resistive load. Now, first of all, the operation will be understood by the conduction of SCRs by the application of AC waveform. First of all, I will consider the application with positive half cycle. Here are the L and N terminals, and this is the rectifier circuit. SCRs T1 and T2 will rectify positive half cycle. T3 and T4 will rectify negative half cycle. First, I will apply the positive half cycle between these two terminals by application of this. Positive half cycle, we can consider polarity at this L terminal positive and N terminal negative, and see if L is positive, then anode of T1, this is the anode terminal of SCR T1, it will be positive, and at the same time cathode of T4 will be positive. If T1 anode is positive and T4 cathode is positive, then see the diode operation, because SCR construction is similar to diode. It is the anode and it is the cathode, and if the voltage is applied and positive terminal of this voltage is connected to anode and negative terminal with cathode, this diode will be forward bias. For understanding, I am considering the example of diode. Here, this is the anode and this is the cathode. Anode is connected with negative, cathode is connected to positive. Therefore, this diode will be in reverse bias condition. On the basis of this, the considered circuit may be drawn in other way. Since T1 anode is connected with positive like this, therefore this SCR T1 may be forward biased by application of this polarity. If proper magnitude of gate signal is applied at required instant, therefore since T1 is T1 can conduct, therefore I will make it with short circuit. This is the L terminal, it is the positive, and since T4 cathode is connected to positive like this diode, therefore T4 will be represented with open circuit, since it will not conduct. At the same time, this T3 will be open circuit, see this diagram, it is the negative. Here is the T3 anode is connected with negative. T4 cathode is connected to negative due to this line. Therefore, T3 will be reverse biased according to this diagram. T3 is reverse biased, therefore it will be open. And here T2 cathode is connected to negative terminal like this diode, therefore T2 will be forward biased. And if T2 is forward biased, then this will be now here is the load between terminals A and B. Now see this circuit diagram, what will be the current path due to application of this positive half cycle? The current will start flowing from this positive terminal L and then it is the anode of T1, it is the cathode of T1, then from L current will start from anode to cathode of T1, then after flowing in T1, here is no path because T3 is open, therefore current will automatically flow in this load from A to B, creating positive polarity here and negative polarity at bottom side of this output voltage. Now here see, current will flow in this load like this, then will reach at this point, and after reaching this point, current will not go like this because this path is open, then certainly current will flow like this because here is the anode of T2 and here is the cathode of T2. Then from T1 anode to cathode, current will flow into the load RL and direction of the current will be from A to B. And then from load, current will flow into T2 from anode to cathode. And after T2, it will come to N terminal. See the direction of load current from A to B when positive half cycle is applied. So this is the conduction diagram when positive half cycle is applied. It is known as conduction diagram. On the basis of this, we will also explain the operation of this circuit with the help of waveform. Now, since it is a full wave rectifier, therefore operation is divided into two parts. First, positive half cycle operation and then negative half cycle operation. Now, the second case is application of negative half cycle. See the first rectifier circuit, these are the 4 SCRs, It is a supply L terminal, N terminal. Now we will apply this negative half cycle. By application of negative half cycle, it is assumed that N will be positive and L will be negative. When N is positive, what will happen? If N is positive, here it will be positive. And if L is negative, here will be negative. Now see the effect of this polarity at L and N. If N is positive and if here polarity is positive, then anode of T3 will be positive. If anode of T3 is positive, then according to this circuit, what will happen? T3 will be forward biased. If a proper magnitude gate signal is applied at required instant. Now, see this T2 cathode is connected with positive, therefore it will be reverse biased. At the same time, see the T4 cathode is connected to negative, and if T4 cathode is connected to negative, then it will follow this diode circuit, and therefore T4 will be forward biased. Hence, by application of this voltage, we can prove that T1 and T2 are reverse biased, because at anode of T1 there is a negative and at cathode of T2 there is a positive. Therefore, for this circuit, the conduction diagram will be like this. T1 will be reverse biased. Therefore, it will be considered as open circuit. T4 cathode is connected to negative, therefore it will be forward bias with proper gate signal magnitude. Now see that T3 anode is connected with positive terminal, therefore T3 will be forward biased, and it will be represented with short circuit. Now see that T2 cathode is connected with positive, therefore it will be in reverse bias condition, and it will be represented with open circuit, and this is the load. Now see what will be the current direction in this circuit. See, N is positive, therefore current will start flowing from N terminal, current will flow not in T2 because it is open circuited, will flow like this. It is the anode and it is the cathode. In any SCR, current always flows from anode to cathode. Therefore, after N, current will flow in T3 from anode to cathode. Current will reach here. Current will not flow in this direction due to reverse bias of T1. Therefore, current will divert in this direction in the load. And what will be the direction of current in the load? Will be certainly from A to B. So therefore, in RL, current will be from A to B. After RL, current will come at this point, and current will not go into T2 because it is open circuit. Current will certainly go in T4. It is the anode of T4 and it is the cathode of T4. Anode to cathode of T4. After T4, current will go to L terminal. Now see, this is the conduction diagram of this bridge rectifier or bridge AC to DC converter. See the direction of load current. When positive half cycle is connected, current in the load is flowing from A to B. Again, see this circuit. When negative half cycle is applied, current is flowing in the load from A to B. What we have applied? We have applied first positive half cycle and then negative half cycle. Means we have applied positive and negative half cycle. Means we have applied bidirectional current. Positive and negative means bidirectional current. But what we are obtaining, when positive half cycle is applied, current flows from A to B, and when negative half cycle is applied, current also flows from A to B. Means this rectifier circuit is rectifying positive half cycle and negative half cycle both. Therefore, this circuit is acting as full wave AC to DC converter. This is the conduction diagram when positive and negative half cycle are applied. The working of this AC to DC converter can also be understood with the help of waveform, and from the waveform we can also calculate the average value of DC voltage, average value of load current, and RMS value of load voltage. Thank you.